Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear student, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In our Pakistan study class, today we are going to talk about the second part of history, chapter 1. Last day, we discussed how the Mughal empire was declined. And today I'm going to discuss with you the British expansion from 1750 to 1850. Yes, sir, as you know that in 1757 in Battle of Plassey, the Robert Clive versus Sajidullah, although it was the defeat of Sajidullah against the Robert Clive, but because of the Mir Jafar, and EIC controlled the first major or proper battle against the Mughals. After this, in 1764, the son of Mir Jafar, Mir Qasim, with the help of the French, again launched a war against the EIC in Battle of Buxar. But unfortunately, this was also unsuccessful, and that is the success of the British. After this battle in we come to know that in the British Parliament a act was passed. It is called Pitt Indian Acts. According to this act, British Parliament reduced the main power of EIC, and the Parliament directly take control of the Indian position. The head of EIC became Governor General, and he has authority to appoint the Prime Minister Governor to organize the army and make decision. And then we also know about the monster of Mysore, Sultan Tipu. Tipu Sultan, very strong Muslim ruler. You can say that one of the last Muslim ruler who resist against the British. But unfortunately, in 1799, in another British war, Anglo-Mysore war against the Tipu Sultan, British over there again bribed one of the person, Mir Sadiq. With the help of this, they entered into the fort of Sultan. Even some of the advisor advised him to leave this place and save the life, but he refused. In Urdu, I use one sentence: Sher ki ek din ki zindagi gidar ki 100 saal ki zindagi se behtar hai. He refused to left and faced the consequences, and he was martyred in Battle of Mysore in 1799, and that was the last major effort by the Muslims against the British. After this, Tipu Sultan, in 1803, the British captured the Delhi, and they defeated the Mughal, the Shah Alam. And Shah Alam accepted the British rule. So from this year onward, Mughal are under the control of the British. In 1818, the British lost one of their battle against the Marathas. The British defeat the Marathas actually in this battle, and the Marathas were under the control of the British. In 1841, the annexation of Sindh, the British and was defeated in the Afghanistan, but for their face saving, they attack on the Sindh ruler, Amirs. Although they have their friendship treaty, but they attack first, and in return they attack. In this way they capture this. And last one, the annexation of Punjab and NWFE after the death of Ranjit Singh, British enter into the whole subcontinent. It means they have taken control of the whole subcontinent in 100 years. These all are their success. Now I'm going to discuss some of their failure of the British. For example, in 1782, the British army was defeated from the hands of the Marathas, and they signed a treaty of friendship with them. British lost their army and some of other things as well in this war. Second, in 1782, the British was also defeated from the hands of the Sultan Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan, and they also lost their prestige, their army as well. And the most important one was when the British majority of the army was killed in Afghanistan, and as being a superpower of the world, that was their major loss. Not only lost, even they lost majority of their army over there. So beta, when we have a question, success and failure of the British between 1750 to 1850, so these are the two areas which I have discussed with you. First, I have discussed all the successes: Battle of Plassey, Buxar, Indian Pact, Act, Mysore Battle 1799, capture of Delhi 1803, annexation of Sindh in 1841, and annexation of Punjab and NWFE in 1849. These are the successes, and failure are defeat in 1782 from the hands of Marathas, at the same year 1782 from the hands of the Sultan Tipu, and the one of the major battle against Afghanistan they have lost. These are the failure. So beta, in this way you can answer your question with the help of these successes and failure. In this way you can attempt your 40 mark question, because examiner asks the question, the success, how successful the Indian expansion by the British between 1750 till 1850. So this is a very simple answer which I have discussed with you, which I have shared with you. I have discussed the key points of all these. You can easily answer your question, beta. First, listen this clip, and with the help of this clip, you can easily understand the key points of the successes and the failure. And again, you take the help from the book, either the Kelly or the Smith, and then you can easily answer your question, beta. Thank you, beta. Jazakallah. And best of luck. Allah.